Welcome to Dispatches from India, a show by People's Dispatch, where we bring you major news developments from India, the issues Indians are talking about, and the implications these will have on politics, economy, and society. We will first get into the News This Week section. As we discussed in the show earlier, a horrific incident of four protesting farmers being overrun by a car on October 3 had shook the country. The main accused in the case is Ashish Mishra, the son of the Union Minister of State, Ajay Mishra. He was finally arrested nearly a week after the incident. Over the past few weeks, farmers have been protesting in various parts of the country, demanding justice for those who were killed. Farmers' organizations, which have been leading the 10-month-long protest, are planning major agitations as well. Hanan Mola, General Secretary of the Farmers' Organization, the All India Kisan Sabha, talks about some of the upcoming protests and demonstrations.
में लखीमपुर जो हत्या हो गया, इस हत्या के खिलाफ भी हम आंदोलन, एक ब्रांच आंदोलन खुल गया. मेन आंदोलन चल रहा था पूरा देश में.
तीन कई शाखाएं खुल गई.
शाखाएं खुल गई. शाखाएं खुल गए. हरियाणा में खुल गया शाखाएं. हम लड़ाई लड़ा, उसको क्षतिपूर्ति किया. असम में आंदोलन कर रहा है खून के खिलाफ, ये भी आ गया. यहाँ हमारा मांग है, पहले प्रोग्राम है 12 तारीख को अक्टूबर में, उसका भोग का दिवस है
जो अंतिम अर्दास,
अंतिम अर्दास. तो 5 के अंतिम अर्दास वहाँ होगा, उसमें हम किसानों को आने के लिए बोल रहे हैं, उसका श्रद्धांजलि दिया जाएगा. और उसी दिन पूरा देश में हम अपील करेगा किसानों को जो अपना अपना जगह में श्रद्धांजलि दे. और उसके बाद 18 तारीख होगा अक्टूबर का, सुबह 8 बजे से लेकर 4 बजे तक रेल रोको होगा. सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट के खिलाफ भी कुछ एक्शन होना चाहिए, इसलिए 18 तारीख रेल रोको होगा. और आखिर में इस महीना का 26 अक्टूबर लखनऊ में बड़ा रैली होगा. दिल्ली लखनऊ चलो महापंचायत होगा, जैसा मुजफ्फरनगर में हुआ था, लाखों लोग आया था. यहाँ भी बड़ा लोग आएगा, यूपी का सेंटर है लखनऊ, तो वहाँ से पूरा देश में बात फैलाएगा, इसलिए वहाँ महापंचायत.
We now go to the state of Jammu and Kashmir, where authorities have dismissed 17 persons from government services on charges of working against the state. The first spate of dismissals was carried out within a month after the authorities announced the formation of a special task force in April this year to crack down on government employees suspected of being anti-national. Through a change in the law, the requirement of a hearing and inquiry prior to dismissal was done away with in cases of national security. Idris Jan Mir is among the three employees sacked last week by the administration. The charges against them were not specified. Also fired was Dr. Abdul Bari Naik, a teacher who was arrested in March and released only earlier this month. Here is a ground report.
So it's not the security of the state which is under threat. It's basically the ideology of a given party which they feel is under threat, and that's why they are resorting to these draconian orders.
हमें इंसान की हर एक इंसान को फंडामेंटल राइट है, जो फ्रीडम ऑफ स्पीच है, वो कोई भी बात कहे जो उसके दिमाग में हो. और अगर कहीं गवर्नमेंट या कोई और जो है ऑर्गेनाइजेशन अगर कहीं पे गलत कोई स्टेप उठाए, तो टीचर ही नहीं बल्कि हर एक इंसान को ये हक है. और यहाँ पे तो डेमोक्रेटिक हक है कि हम कोई बात भी कर सकते, लेकिन उसका भी इन लोगों ने मौका नहीं दिया.
आई होप दैट द गवर्नमेंट हैज नॉट डिसाइडेड टू मेक द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन इन ऑपरेशनल इन जम्मू एंड कश्मीर. द पीपल ऑफ जम्मू एंड कश्मीर डू हैव द राइट टू एक्सप्रेस देमसेल्व्स और टू बी हर्ड बिफोर टेकिंग एनी एक्शन अगेंस्ट एनी सिटीजन एंड फॉर एम्प्लॉइज एज वेल.
इसका आइडिया था कि गलत नहीं होना चाहिए कहीं पे कोई नरेगा काम, खासकर स्पेशली नरेगा कामों पर, क्योंकि नेशनल के हैं, इसमें पीडीपी के हैं. तो कहीं इसने दे दिया इनके खिलाफ कि ये ग्राउंड लेवल पर कुछ नहीं करते हैं. एक्चुअली ये वो तो पैसे निकालते थे गवर्नमेंट से, गवर्नमेंट खजानों से, ट्रेजरियों से, लेकिन काम तो कोई ग्राउंड लेवल पर नहीं होती थी. उसी के खिलाफ इसने आरटीआई भी डाले हैं. तो इस सिलसिले में पता नहीं क्या हो गया, ये तो हमारी ही बदकिस्मती है, यहाँ सच बोलना जुर्म है.
Next we get into our In Focus section, where we take a deeper look at some of the burning issues in the country today. Over the past few years, there has been a huge demand for domestic services, including cleaning, maintenance, and personal care. A number of companies have emerged, which through apps send workers to provide these services at home. one of the biggest in India, is Urban Company. However, the company employs these workers, a large number of whom are women, as partners on a contract basis. This means that they have no standard wage, service allowance, or fixed working hours. The issues faced by these workers were amplified during the pandemic. On October 8, hundreds of women protested outside of the company's head office in Haryana, voicing their demands. The company responded with a 12-point program, which promised to improve partner earnings and livelihood, but the workers feel that many of their concerns have not been addressed. Here is a ground report on the issues faced by the workers.
कोई भी काम कर रहे हैं और हमारे पास प्रोडक्ट नहीं है, तो कंपनी उस पे प्रेशराइज करती है कि आप कहीं से भी अरेंज कर लो, लेकिन आप ये बुकिंग ले लो। ठीक, दूसरा, अगर हमें कोई भी परेशानी कस्टमर के घर पे होती है, तो उसके लिए कोई हेल्प सेंटर नहीं है हमारे पास।
कोविड आया, कोविड आने से पहले इनकी अर्बन कंपनी हो गई। अर्बन कंपनी में आने के बाद इन लोगों ने हमारे साथ क्रेडिट की भी प्रॉब्लम कर दी। इन्होंने हमारे साथ प्रेशर कर दिया कि आप दिन में इतनी जॉब करोगे, इतनी लीड करोगे, और महीने का इन्होंने टारगेट कर दिया 50 टारगेट करने के बाद ना इन्होंने कहा कि अगर आप 50 जॉब नहीं करोगे तो आपकी 2,000 रुपये पेनल्टी लगेगी। अब लड़कियां क्या करेगी? अब कोविड का भी समय, अपने घर परिवार को भी देखना, और कोविड में लड़की कितना भागेगी, कैसे भाग सकती, नहीं भाग सकती ना।
सो यू हैव दिस न्यू मेट्रिक कॉल्ड रिस्पांस रेट एंड देन देयर आर पेनलाइजेशंस ऑन दैट और देयर आर प्रेशर्स पुट ऑन वुमेन। यू नो द मोमेंट यू हैव अ मेट्रिक इट बिकम्स अ वे फॉर द कंपनी टू टेल वुमेन दैट दे आर नॉट एज गुड एज द एवरेज अमाउंट ऑफ यू नो द फ्लीट ऑफ पार्टनर्स, राइट? दे डोंट एक्चुअली हैव द फ्रीडम देन to choose the work they want to do with the flexibility that they want. And you have to realize that every time there is a relationship of power, there is some kind of imposition that happens, you know? Like, there is no free will here. So the rating system, the opaque kind of like systems that drive these penalties that people are not aware of, some of these penalties are just absolutely horrible, I would say. There's no way to justify them. I would like to see the company try to justify them.
यहाँ पर जैसे भी हमें कोई प्रॉब्लम होती है या फिर हमारी कोई आईडी ब्लॉक हो जाए या फिर हम कहीं कंप्लेन भी करें या ऑफिस भी जाएं जाकर कंप्लेन करते हैं अपनी, तो हमारी सुनवाई कोई होती नहीं है, जिसके लिए हम ऑफिस में जाके बात भी करके आए हैं। कई बार हमने 10-10 लड़कियाँ भी गई हैं कि हमारी आईडी ब्लॉक हो गई है या कोई परेशानी है या कोई भी चीज़ है, तो कंपनी की तरफ से ना तो इसके लिए कोई हमारे लिए बैठा हुआ है, ना ही कोई सुनवाई होती है। बस हमें सिर्फ ये बोल दिया जाता है, हाँ ठीक है, हम देखेंगे, बस इतना ही बोल करके हमें वहाँ से भेज दिया जाता है।
Indians have been suffering from massive fuel price hikes over the past year and more. Average prices across the four metropolitan cities have increased by 26% for petrol and 31% for diesel in the past 1 year. This has had a cascading effect, as every sector of life has been affected. A major reason for these high prices is the continuous hikes in excise taxes by the government. Among the worst hit by these hikes are the poor, both in urban and rural areas. Journalist Anindya Chakrabarty explains how they are affected.
Fuel price hikes hurt the poor the most, not only because petrol and diesel have an impact on prices across the board, but also because they affect directly what the poor use. And I'm going to take only two examples for you. I'm going to take a lower middle class employee or someone who's self-employed in a city or a town who earns about 15,000 rupees a month. You know that you come across such people all the time. And I'm also going to take a small farmer who has about 2 acres of agricultural land. So how does it affect them? Let's just look at it. I'm going to start with the person who is the urban worker, urban employee who earns about 15,000 rupees. All right. They have a bike, right? You know, because they live on the outskirts of the city. They have to travel to work. And a bike is cheaper because public transport is very bad in our cities and public transport is expensive. So they use bikes. So I'm going to take mileage of 30 kilometers per hour, 35, 40 and 45. And I'm going to look at the petrol prices about 2 years ago when it was approximately about 75 rupees. And I'm going to take petrol prices, which is hovering around 105 rupees depending on which city you're in. And then I'm going to calculate the change. Okay, so at 30 kilometers per liter, where the fuel bill is the maximum, it used to be 2600 earlier 2 years ago, now it's 3640. Why? Because I'm taking 26 working days here. The change is a little more than 1000 rupees is being spent just on commute. Okay, if it's 35 kilometers per liter, you have the numbers on your screen, it's about 890 rupees extra. 40 kilometers per liter mileage, the difference that comes is about 780 rupees per month for 26 days. And at 45 kilometers per liter, where the petrol bill is the lowest, it used to be about 1730 odd, it's gone up to about 2400, the difference is close to 700 rupees. Now you'll say that is not much, but remember, this person earns just 15,000 rupees. And also remember, it's most likely that their salaries have not increased because of COVID and the slowdown. Chances are they were sacked at the peak of the COVID wave, have got another job back, probably at a lower salary. So in any case, just a single increase, the increase in petrol prices has increased their costs relative to their salary by 5 to 7%. That's a huge increase. Okay, let me look at farmers, and here I'm looking at farmers who own up to 2 acres of land. And what are their expenses? Where do they use fuel? They use diesel to power their water pumps, and they use diesel for tractors, harvesters, threshers, and stuff like that. The government's own committee calculations show that for paddy, for an entire season, per acre, about 103 liters of diesel are used. Okay. I'm taking various sources, I'm taking an average here, 103 liters of diesel per acre per season for paddy. For wheat, it's lower because wheat requires less irrigation, less water. It's 83 liters per acre of diesel. That's the cost per season for a 2 acre, for 1 acre of land. So we have to now multiply that by 2. So what am I going to do? I'm going to look at the average yield and multiply that per acre and multiply that by 2 to say what is the likely output. How much extra minimum support price have these farmers got in these 2 years? The difference is 125 rupees per quintal for paddy and 175 rupees per quintal for wheat. So you understand that if a farmer owns 2 acres of land, right, or any, for instance, per quintal of paddy, they're actually earning 54 rupees less compared to the MSP that has gone up. 54 rupees less compared to 2 years ago, right? Just because of diesel prices. Forget about rise in fertilizer prices. Forget about other prices that have gone up, seeds, etc. Just diesel prices means they're losing out by about 54 rupees on diesel alone on paddy. On wheat, they are just gaining about 9 rupees. That is it. That is the gain. And that little gain that they're getting because of the MSP hike is being lost because of the hike in prices of other things, which itself is caused by fuel price hike, because fuel prices affect freight, they affect everything and cause an overall inflation. That is why the poor are the most likely to be the worst hit by fuel price hikes. Don't believe the propaganda that they are not affected by this.
That's all there is for this week. Next week, we'll be back with more news from India. To know more about these and other such stories, keep watching People's Dispatch.